Please rise. Starting with this side of the room, please state your name, troop number, and where you earned your Eagle.
Doug Rogers, Troop 77, Andover, Massachusetts.
Tom Murphy, Troop 32, Foxborough, Massachusetts.
Joel Fiskus, Troop 244, Detroit, Michigan.
Tim Gruzzi, Troop 2, Lonsdale, Ohio.
Thank you. Now, if you would all please rise. Color guard, please bring forth the colors in this court of honor. Corey Ward will now lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Corey. Color guard, please post the colors. Mayor, attend your post. Kyle Scouten will now lead us in the Scout Oath. Jeremy Citro will now lead us in the Scout Law.
A Scout
is trustworthy, loyal, helpful, friendly, courteous, kind, obedient, cheerful, thrifty, brave, clean, and reverent.
Thank you, Jeremy. Good afternoon. My name is TJ Kelly, and I am a Life Scout with Troop 702. I am honored to serve as the Master of Ceremonies as we honor Alexander Guzzi for his attainment of Scouting's highest rank, Eagle Scout. This is a moment worthy of celebration. At this time, I would like to ask Benjamin House, Star Scout of Troop 702, to open the ceremony with a prayer. You can be seated. Let's pray.
Dear Lord, I thank you for this day. I thank you for this opportunity to come together and serve the highest achievement in scouting, the Eagle. I pray that you bless us throughout our day and that we grow up in better understanding of you. For Jeremiah 29:11 says, for I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and to not harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Amen.
Thank you, Ben. Now I'd like to call upon our Scoutmaster, Mr. John Myers, to officially convene this court of honor.
Good afternoon, everybody. By the power vested in me, by the National Council of the Boy Scouts of America and the Spirit of Adventure Council, I now declare this Court of Honor to be duly convened for the purpose of presenting the highest achievement of the Boy Scouts of America, the Eagle Scout Award, to Alexander Guzzi. The 110th Eagle Scout in Troop 702 in Reading, Massachusetts, now in its second century of service. The Eagle Award is the highest award given to a scout who has attained the ideals and the goals of the Boy Scouts of America. The path towards Eagle is both long and challenging. However, those scouts who have worked hard and practiced the principles outlined in the Scout Oath and the Scout Law have received To receive the Eagle Award requires many tasks, in addition to minimum time service and a display of leadership qualities. A scout must earn 21 merit badges, 12 of which are EGLE required. He must serve in troop leadership positions for a total of 16 months. And he must serve his community with outstanding service and conservation projects for at least 13 hours, not to mention the hours he spent on his own Eagle Scout project. In total, he has completed over 325 requirements. All of these achievements provide the basis of supplying worthy citizens in our communities from within the ranks of scouting. TJ, you're up.
Thank you, Mr. Myers. We are here to honor Eagle Scout Alex, but this is not the first time he's been recognized before a court of honor. Six times before, he has received rank advancements. First, when he received his scout badge. Then, when he earned each rank leading to Eagle. Each time, he grew a little taller, became wiser, and even more dedicated to the ideals of scouting. Let's take a moment to reflect back on the steps he took on the road to Eagle. As a new scout, he wore the fleur-de-lis, the symbol of scouting around the world. The three parts of the fleur-de-lis represent the three parts of the scout oath, which he is beginning to learn and live. As a tenderfoot scout, he wore a badge with an eagle and a shield, representing our country, and two stars that represent truth and knowledge. His second class scout badge is a scroll inscribed with the scout motto, "Be prepared." Suspended from the scroll is a knot that is a reminder to do a good turn every day. His first class scout badge shows the complete scout emblem, fleur-de-lis, eagle and shield, stars and scroll, indicating the completion of basic scout training. His star scout badge symbolizes the unlimited opportunities that lie before him, just like the stars in the night sky. A star scout can shine as brightly as any of them. His light scout badge, one step from eagle, is a heart that shows that scouting's lessons have been taken to heart, so that the scout is now ready to spread his wings and fly. In just a few short years, our Eagle Scout has undergone a transformation, from struggling to learn and memorize the words of the Scout Oath and Law to becoming one who lives those words. But who is our Eagle Scout? First and foremost, of course, he is an outdoorsman. He knows how to camp, swim, hike, use wood tools, build a fire, use a camp stove, and find his way with a map and compass. He spent at least 20 days and nights camping out in a tent he pitched on a site he selected. Many of those times he planned his own menu and cooked his own food. The Eagle Scout is comfortable with nature. He can identify local animals and plants, including poisonous plants. He understands the causes of water, land, and air pollution. He developed a project to solve an environmental problem. He embodies the scout model, be prepared. He knows how to treat fractures, head injuries, hypothermia, convulsions, frostbite, burns, abdominal pain, muscle cramps, even knocked out teeth. He knows what to do in case of fire, explosion, desert emergency, motor vehicle accident, mountain accident, food poisoning, gas leak, earthquake, flood, tornado, hurricane, and avalanche. The Eagle Scout is a good citizen. He's been to a town meeting and knows how the town government is organized. He knows who his U.S. senators and representatives are, and has written a letter to one of them about a national issue. He's read the Declaration of Independence and the U.S. Constitution. He knows how to manage his money and understands the risks and benefits of putting his money in saving bonds, mutual funds, common stock, and real estate. He has set financial goals and worked toward achieving those goals. The Eagle Scout has also set and worked toward fitness goals. He's competed against himself in tests of aerobic endurance, flexibility, and muscular strength. He knows what it means to be both physically, mentally, and socially fit. He's a good family member. He knows what things are important to the members of his family and has talked to his family about finances, drug abuse, and growing up. All of these things he did in order to earn the merit badges required for Eagle. Beyond those, he earned 9 elective merit badges, which introduced him to such subjects as aviation, canoeing, scuba diving, chemistry, electricity, geocaching, fishing, and shooting. So what is an Eagle Scout? Well, to quote the 1938 Handbook for Scoutmasters, he is a young man who is qualified to help others as well as take care of himself. His badge is not a decoration, but rather a symbol of knowledge and ability. I'd like to ask Scoutmaster Myers to present the Eagle Charge.
Thank you. So before I start with the Scoutmaster Charge, does everybody have a program handy? It's okay if you don't. And just like everybody noticed, and I'll read one section for you. It's the part where you see Alex's picture on it. And it's the third paragraph I'd like to read for you guys. Alex climbed rapidly through the ranks and accumulated merit badges quickly. Well, at first. He made it to first class in his first year. That's great. He advanced to star in 9 months, and then life 9 months after that. This is the funny part. Then he would spend over 3.5 years as a life scout. Way to stick it out.
Good job.
You're making this scouting experience all you can make it, right?
Yeah.
Scoutmaster Charge, here we go. Becoming an Eagle Scout is a great accomplishment. Being an Eagle Scout is a great responsibility. As an Eagle, the Scout Oath and the Scout Law should take on a new meaning for you. The motto and the slogan take on a new urgency. As an Eagle, your first obligation is to live with honor. You are a marked man, a leader, for good or ill. People will follow the example you set. Give up anything before you give up your reputation and good name. As Shakespeare said, my honor is my life. Both grow in one. Take honor from me, and my life is done. Let the white of the Eagle badge remind you of honor. Your second obligation as an Eagle Scout is to be loyal. As a follower, you promise to be loyal to those above you. Now, as a leader, you must also be loyal to those below you, treating them as you would want to be treated. And you must always be loyal to your ideals, not letting others sway you from your course. Let the blue of the Eagle badge remind you of loyalty. Your third obligation as an Eagle Scout is to be courageous. Stepping into your new role as a leader, you will face many challenges and obstacles. A ship in the harbor is safe, but that's not what ships are for. You must have the courage to do what is right, whatever other people do or say. Let the red of the Eagle badge remind you of courage. Your fourth obligation is to serve others. For a leader is above all a servant. Let the practice of the daily good turn become a lifetime of service. For only in giving of yourself do you give anything of value. Just as you always have, let the scroll on your badge remind you of service. Your final obligation as an Eagle Scout is to have vision. As a leader, you must now blaze your own trail. Just as the bald eagle soaring high above the ground can look far into the distance, so too must you look far into the future. Many people will follow you. Only with vision will you lead them in the right direction. Let the silver of the eagle hanging from your badge remind you of vision. These are your obligations as an Eagle Scout. Honor, loyalty, courage, service, and vision. By meeting those obligations, you can lead your troop, your community, and your nation toward a better tomorrow. You get all that?
Good.
I think it's time to recognize some other people other than Alex today, huh? How about his parents? Come on. So Alex, your parents have been your primary source of all and strength. Stand right there. Pay attention. Stand up. So Alex, no one will ever know the unnumbered acts of self-sacrifice your mother has made.
I do.
For many emails and everything else. In recognition of your mother's devotion, I'd like you to present her with the Eagle Mother's pin.
You have to be there at certain times, but with scouting, it's not quite that way, as we've seen with Alex. That, you know, other things come up, you know, whether it be a drama club or whatever, school, or obviously the AP classes and you know, volleyball and all the other things that he did. That's all great, and so I think Alex has really managed that work very well. Alex's Eagle Project, many of you may have seen it when you came in, but the front of the church was kind of overgrown with big shrubs, and it was pretty old and needed work. And so Alex entertains that doing something for the front. He met with the trustees of the church and kind of developed some concepts and got, you know, discussed it with them. And he really managed the whole thing. So he developed. He spoke with some landscape architects to kind of get some professional input. Again, that with the trustees, he got all the approvals needed through scouting and through the council here at the troop, and did the fundraising and all the pieces to it, which was terrific. It kind of reminded me of you know, the importance of this, and this is not just something that's done for the sake of a project. It's really a life lesson. When my son Luke went to the dinner that council holds for all the new Eagles, the speaker was someone who was heading up a healthcare program. And he said when he applied to the job, he never thought he'd get it because he didn't really know that much about it. But he got it, and so there were a lot of problems that had to be developed. And he said he approached it like his Eagle Project. He got together a group of really smart people. They looked at all the funding, they developed a work plan, and they executed it, and it was very successful. So, you know, this is, you can use this as a model throughout your life. It's really a tremendous opportunity that not too many organizations will have, especially at this age. I would say that Alex has lived the Scout law as well as any Scout that I have known. He is always trustworthy, loyal, helpful, friendly, courteous, kind, obedient, cheerful, brave, and they all apply to Alex. But a few that really stand out in my mind are friendly, courteous, kind, cheerful, and brave. He's always has a smile, he's always polite, and ready to lend a hand whenever one is needed. But I think the one that I'll never forget about Alex is brave. Because as talked about in the program, there was a terrible storm during the NYLT, and you know, there was a lightning strike. And so Alex was in the hospital. The next day, he went back to camp, and then the following summer, spent the whole summer up there. You know, that's obvious by itself. It's a very difficult thing. I mean, there was in the recent Adult Leader magazine, there was an article about an adult in Texas, Adult Leader, that rescued somebody from a stream. You know, just his reflexes kicked in and he helped the person. But in Alex's case, he had time to think about it. In some ways, that's even harder. And so to be able to conquer that fear, to go back the next day and then go back for the summer, I just have a tremendous amount of admiration for your strength. Really, really very impressive. The founder of Scouting, Lord Baden Powell, said, "We are not a club or a Sunday school class, but a school of the woods." Alex has benefited tremendously from his time in the woods, and the troop has benefited tremendously by having Alex as a member. So I'd say congratulations to Alex and his parents. Lord Baden Powell would say, well done to all of you.
Thank you, Mr. Sullivan. Alex, please recognize the patience and sage advice Mr. Sullivan provided you with the Scouting Mentor Pen. Now Mr. Myers will administer the Eagle Scout Pledge.
So we're not doing too bad. I think we've probably got about 3 hours to go. Where are all my Eagle Scouts? You thought we were done with you, we're not. Do you have a program handy? I have one for you. As the candidate takes this pledge for the first time, will those Eagle Scouts who are present in the audience please stand and reaffirm their pledge? Don't worry, you don't have to do it from memory. Give the scout sign and repeat after me in unison, or with me in unison. Let's do it together. It can be found on the cover of your handout. Here we go. Ready? On my honor, I will do my best to do my duty to God. On my honor, I will do my best to do my duty to my country. I reform the allegiance of the three promises of the Scout Book.
I fully recognize and take upon myself the obligations and responsibilities of the rank of the Eagle Scout. On my honor, I will do my best to give my training an example and my neighborhood.
This country is not getting very confusing to hear it twice. Alex, I charge you to enter this Eagle Scout Brotherhood holding ever before you without reservation the ideals of honor and service. By repeating the Eagle Scout pledge before your fellow members, you have become an Eagle Scout. Through the words you used just now are similar to those in which you used joining scouting. Today they mean more than they ever could have meant at that time. Or at that time. Let's start this one again. Because I was confusing myself. So the words you just used now are similar to those which you joined scouting. Today they mean more than they ever could have meant at that time. Or at any time in the past. When you pledge yourself on the sacred honor using the same words which are found at the end of the Declaration of Independence, you sealed your eternal loyalty to the code of the Eagle Scout. By the authority vested in me by the National Court of Honor of the Boy Scouts of America, it is my privilege and pleasure to pronounce you an Eagle Scout. May the oath you have taken remain true in your heart. Ladies and gentlemen, scouts and scouters, I present to you Eagle Scout Alexander Doozy.
Good afternoon, everyone. I hope you're all having a great time. thank you all for attending. It's a wonderful thing to have you all here at my Eagle Scout ceremony. It's been quite a long road, but my time in scouting has been everything I've expected to be, and far more. So I started my scouting career way back in Pack 735 as a Tiger Cub. In Cub Scouts, I learned how to become a scout to my den leader, Mr. Whitney, and I found that I had a passion for the outdoors, whatever the weather. One of my most memorable trips as a Cub Scout was sleeping on the USS Constitution. My Cub Scout pack and I crammed into the sleeping quarters with bunks stretching much higher than I could reach at the time. Although I enjoyed the trip, I always remembered the sacrifices the adults had made for us on that trip. The sleeping arrangements on the USS Constitution were far from passable. They had a special way of only letting you get a good night's sleep if you were under the age of 10 and your back was in pristine condition. If you didn't meet either of those categories, it was going to be a long, long night, whether you wanted it or not. Later on, I gained much more appreciation for sleeping conditions as I entered Boy Scouts. My first summer up at camp, it rained 3 feet, not only because that was my average height at the time, but when I woke up, my tent platform was floating when I went down for breakfast. My tentmate managed to keep all his stuff dry by keeping his clothes in a footlocker, an idea I was sure to follow every summer after. But my scoutmaster at the time, Mr. Hegarty, showed me that the weather doesn't dictate the trip. Rain or shine, it seemed, Mr. Hegarty always had an activity in his back pocket to keep the troop going, or whether his extensive knowledge of hiking trails or past trips he had taken with the troop, or even a game to keep the younger kids distracted. My first few years in 702 showed me that no matter what situation I faced, the perspective decided what I would get out of it. As I continued in my scouting career, I was eager to go on trip after trip. In my first few years, I went with the troop to Acadia National Park in Gettysburg. These trips were some of my most memorable, not only because the activities the troop did were amazing and fun, but because in my first years of scouting, I learned not only how to become a scout, but I also formed bonds with the scouts who I would come to know as very close friends in future years. Summer camp became a highlight year after year, and I began to call people that I once knew as counselors friends. It was only a matter of time before I joined the Hidden Valley Scout Reservation staff in 2014. The experiences that I had working with people who had the same enthusiasm and eagerness for camping that I did kept me focused on how to make every scouting day a joyous one. I continued to participate in camping trips and earn merit badges with the help of Mr. Sullivan, my Eagle Scout mentor, and my second scoutmaster, Mr. Myers, and so many others along the way. I was able to finish my Eagle Scout rank in March of this year. The people who I have come into contact with over my scouting career have left a lasting impact on me as a person. My friends in the troop have taught me what it means to belong, and I will carry those experiences through my life. The adults in the troop have shown me 1,001 skills. But much more importantly, I've learned from them a sense of charity, of duty, and a sense of honor. They also taught me to take life a little less seriously, something that I still enjoy to hold this day. In addition to my friends and the adults in the troop, I'd like to thank the Old South Methodist Church for giving me a place to do my Eagle Project. Currently, Jared Castelnovo, who is right there, he is currently working on his Eagle Scout project on the left side of the church. Because of the contributions of the many in this troop, and in my nation, and in my town, and in my community, I have learned the ability to change any dull moment into something great. As I look forward to the future, I hope to carry the mindset of Eagle Scout with me wherever I go, and make sure that I make every day super fantastic. Thank you all so much. Much credit for having achieved scouting's highest award. But wear your award with humility. Ever mindful, the Eagle Scout is looked up to as an example. May the Scout Oath and Law be your guide for tomorrow and onward. At this time, I would like to ask Thomas House, First Class Scout of Troop 702, to close our ceremony with a prayer.
Scouters, Reverend. Today, I'll be reading Philippians chapter 4, verses 8 through 9. Finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. What you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, practice these things, and the peace of God will be with you. Thank you.
Thank you, Tom. Would everyone please stand? Collar guard, please retire the colors. This afternoon has indeed been very special. Thank you all for coming out and participating in this wonderful event. Please join us following the ceremony for a reception in honor of Alex downstairs in the vestry. I now declare this Eagle Court of Honor closed.